Hi, I'm Steve Jones and I'm going to tell you something about hydrogen. Now, either I could tell you what it looks like, but that would be difficult because you can't see it, or I could tell you how it's made, how it's made up. And I'm going to do that. I'm going to look at the structure and the atomic structure of hydrogen because it's the simplest of our atomic materials. If we think of protons, and the protons in these diagrams are this symbol, are neutrons. Neutrons and protons are about the same weight, about the same mass, but protons have a positive charge, neutrons have no charge, and electrons are much smaller, a 2/1000th of the size of a proton or a neutron, and are negatively charged. And here we have, in our three diagrams, we have three types of hydrogen. And you'll notice what makes it hydrogen is that we have just one proton in the center and one electron. The electron is not as important because that could be pulled away from the atom and makes the atom charged sometimes, turns it into what we call an ion. But for the moment, let's look at the center, the nucleus. Here we have one proton, one proton, one proton. But in this type of hydrogen, it's still got one proton, but it's getting a neutron as well. And here we have two neutrons. In fact, this doesn't work. This is radioactive. This nucleus breaks up, so it doesn't exist for very long. Now, therefore, we have three different types of hydrogen, and chemically they are identical. You can have water made of hydrogen 1, water made of hydrogen 2, water made of hydrogen 3, and you can also have water made partly of hydrogen 1 and hydrogen 2. So these all exist. So chemically they are the same. They behave in the same way. They react in the same way. But physically they're different, and hydrogen is interesting because hydrogen 2 is twice as heavy as hydrogen 1. And from hydrogen 2, we can get heavy water. And we'll call heavy water because it's H2O. This is also H2O, but this is just ordinary water. And in fact, this is about 10% heavier for the same amount of water. So it's significantly heavier. It's only in the case of hydrogen that this occurs. So hydrogen, what is it like? Well, it's a gas. We can't see it. But we know it burns. It burns very well. It explodes. And when it burns, it produces water because it combines with oxygen to produce H2O, which is water. And this is interesting because both of these materials, hydrogen and oxygen, are very reactive materials, and yet they produce something which to us is not reactive at all, essential to life. So that's a little bit about hydrogen.